Welcome back to my corner on the internet. Okay, so tonight I'm reacting to... I'm reacting to Glee again, right? But this time it's 3 for the price of 1. It's called The Unholy Trinity Dragging Everyone for 9 minutes Straight. So basically Santana, Brittany, and Quinn dragging everyone. We now know that Santana can drag people for filth, but let's watch the other two in action. Okay, so without further ado, I'm about to get into this reaction.
What do you say? You and I reunite a little threesome called the Unholy Trinity?
Three of us are National Show Choir Championship goddesses.
Thanks to a school rule that says we have to let anyone join the club, we're welcoming a new member this week. Rachel, what's her name?
Oh my god.
I'm just trying to be honest.
Hey, dwarf. Anyone ever tell you that you dress like one of the bait girls on To Catch a Predator?
Also,
I'm more talented than you.
The fact that Big just laughed at that. He ain't shit for that.
Every time you open your mouth.
At least she was honest.
Okay, I'm more talented than all of you. I see that clearly now. It's Brittany. Bitch.
Guys.
An opportunity.
No way.
Why not?
Because I don't want to be in a picture with you. You don't get to face.
No, I won't.
Yes, I will. I'll be the one doing it.
Excuse me.
We'd like to send these back.
But you ate all of it.
Look, I'm pretty sure you have to do what we say. And this food was not satisfactory.
There is a mouse in mine.
So we'd like more, please.
All right. Hottest guys in the school. Go.
Okay, Puck's super fine. Finn's cute, too.
Yeah, but he's not hot, though.
He really isn't.
And you know what, Britt? I think that dwarf girlfriend of his is dragging down his rep. I mean, if he were dating, say, popular pretty girls like us, he would go from dumpy to smoking.
Hello? Hey, I'm right here.
Oh, look, we matched periwinkle.
Yeah.
Get a room.
You're the one who complained to Principal Thiggins about me.
Yeah, and I do it all over again after that performance.
You're messing with adult things here, Santana. This is my job. This is my life.
This is my education, and it's not a joke to me, although it seems to be one to you.
What are you talking about? They all love my performance.
Because they don't know any better. It's your fault. You're their teacher. You went from La Cucaracha to a bullfighting mariachi. Why don't you just dress up as the Taco Bell Chihuahua and bark the theme song to Dora the Explorer?
Oh, I'm gonna go.
No,
you're resting.
Oh, this moment is my favorite one.
Set to heart, and I thought long and hard about it, and it occurred to me that you may have a point. Okay, maybe Brittany and I are too young to get married. I mean, after all, that's why it didn't work out with you and Blaine, right? Or maybe it didn't work out because you're a judgmental little Duranophile with a mouth like a cat's ass. Maybe Blaine got tired of hearing a shrill, self-aggrandizing lecture about how you felt the two of you were at the very apex of the gay rights movement every time you so much as cooked macaroni and cheese together or farted. Maybe Blaine didn't want to be with someone who looks like they just removed their top row of dentures every time they smile, or someone who doesn't dress like an extra out of one of Andy Dick's more elaborate wet dreams. Maybe Blaine grew weary of dating a breathier, more feminine Quinn Fabray. Maybe he finally got freaked out by your strange obsession with old people that causes you to skulk around nursing homes like one of those cats that can smell cancer.
Rachel's face. Oh, let me go back. Rachel's face in that moment.
Finally got freaked out by your strange obsession with old people that causes you to skulk around nursing homes like one of those cats that can.
Oh, God. I would have. How do you keep a straight face during this scene? Because I would have started cracking up like that. I don't know.
Smell cancer. Maybe he got tired of watching you drape your yourself on every piano you happen past to entertain exactly no one with. Say some song that Judy Garland choked on her tongue in the middle of. Some sassy old Broadway standard made famous by another dead alcoholic crook. Maybe Brian woke up one day and said, you know what? I don't want to marry a sexless, self-centered baton twirler. Maybe I need someone who knows more than three dance moves. The finger wag, the shoulder shimmy, and the one where you pretend to twirl. Attached to your hips, so you know what, maybe that's why it didn't work out. Maybe it has nothing to do with me and Brittany. Maybe it's just that you are utterly
intolerable.
Maybe that has something to do with it.
No one in this musty choir room compares to my megawatt star power. Blaine, you're shorter than your average lawn gnome. Joe, you look like a Yucatan spider monkey. Tina is, you're Tina.
Maybe I love you, but you're really out of line here. Would you stop texting? I'm trying to talk to you. It's really rude. Did you seriously just break up with me by a text?
As fascinated as I am by your down-filled pillow soft lips that are 10 times too big for your face, I really miss my sweet, sweet lady kisses. Sorry/not sorry. Moving on.
I'm sorry, Coach Sylvester, but something is going on between Finn and that thing. You saw how it was undressing him with its eyes. Eavesdrop much? Time for some girl talk, man hands. You can dance with him, you can sing with him, but you will never have him. I understand why you'd be threatened. Finn and I have made a connection, but I'm an honorable person. I don't need to steal your man. I have plenty of suitors of my own. Every day, Glee status is going up, and
no.
You're slowing down. Deal with it.
Hello.
Can I ask you guys something private?
Yes, you should move to Israel.
I have a proposition to make. A makeover.
I'm in. Makeover should like crack to me. Uh-huh. My suggestion? Spanx. Or a double neck camisole with a control top for the baby bump. Also, baby doll dresses? Dead giveaway.
Not for me, for Rachel.
Why would I want to do that? I admit I like a challenge as much as the next guy, but Rachel somehow manages to dress like a grandmother and a toddler at the same time.
My point exactly. You're as concerned about the Glee Club succeeding as I am, and she's a distraction. Look at her. She's wearing a pantsuit.
She's like she's interning at some office.
Don't you think the judges are gonna take one look at her?
That's not an office. Not a fucking nursery.
Somewhere in that pea brain of yours is a man. Access him and tell him to prove to me that I chose the right guy to have a baby with.
What are you doing?
Proving that Shelby is an unfit mother. First we pant the stuff, then we call child services, starting in the bathroom.
So, like, Kurt should sit with Rachel because they're both a little annoying. No offense. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, I can't hear you. I blocked your voice a few months ago because everything you say is depressing and about you.
Okay, look, Becky.
I won't tell Lauren to look out for poachers who might mistake her for the endangered white rhino.
I heard that. Don't make me rip that weave out your head.
This is not gonna be good.
Hello, Lauren. You are a beautiful person.
Thank you.
Now get out of my way, please, before I end you.
I already know how this ends. But I'm still gonna come and watch him.
But see, I sort of do.
I didn't get a ton
of town
kind of
Lima Heights adjacent. You know where that is, poppin' fresh?
I didn't set up a tripod and two iPhones for nothing. So, I'm not skipping this. Tried to drag her. Santana's gob is bigger than this ring light. You know that, right?
Japanese businessman with a very dark specific fetish, but I actually dig this look. Yay. More backup for me.
You wish.
You know what? I did not just leave one diva-driven glee club to join another, so let me write you a reality check, Richie bitch. I've seen what you can do, and what you can do is stand in the back, sway, and sing very, very quietly.
I
You look terrible.
That's silence, awesome. Isn't it?
Can we just talk about what this really is? Rachel Berry isn't getting her way, so she's punishing the rest of us.
Santana, that's not the case at all.
Stop acting like you're fine and start dealing with your crap. Look, you choked at your big audition. I get it. I'm sorry, but it happens. And I understand that you're pissed off at the universe, but imploding on one of the last nights that we have to spend together because basically you're just not in the mood to dance is maybe the pettiest thing you have ever done. So have fun at your I'm a victim party, acting like you're not some selfish, self-centered, lame-ass wannabe diva from hell, because me, I'm going to go to my senior prom with my girlfriend and my friends.
Mm-hmm. She is a bitch. B-I-C-T-H.
Bye, Guth.
In that order. Okay. Nice good to end it on. what can I say? Quinn and Brittany, they're going against dragon people, but honestly, no one can outdrag Santana. And Sue is a close second. Either way, I enjoyed this video. Okay, so that's it for this video. Like and subscribe if you want. I post if whenever I feel like it, and I'll see you next one. Bye.